So I was gonna start today with 25 push-ups and 25 sit-ups, and I still may. It's Saturday. And my head hurts. It's like almost noon time, and I woke up around 7. It hurts. I've taken meds, and it's kind of easing off, but it's not where I should be right now. And so I think I'm gonna do them either way, and it's gonna hurt. But I got to. I made a promise to Caleb, and I just got confirmed that his brother Jared's gonna help out. I made a promise. I don't break my promises, so it's gonna hurt. But I'm gonna get it done here in a bit, and so I can knock it off. What I'm also gonna do kinda wanna show my progression. So what I'm gonna do with that is I'm just gonna take a quick photo of my belly. That's hard. So yeah. Plan to go all the way down. I gotta ease my way back into this. So, oh crap! I can't even freaking put my legs back. Ah, dude. All right. Gracie. And if you can't tell, I have no strength in my knees, so it's doing it girl style, which is what they taught back in high school. I'm not saying anything about no females, I'm sorry. You know, I have no strength down on my knees. Hopefully I'll be able to build it up over time. So, let's do this again, huh? Come on. I can't.
Okay. I don't know how much that was. It was nowhere near 25. Gracie, come on. Small goals. Halem said small goals. First goal is to hit 25. Okay. He was 20. So I gotta crush the first one. That didn't count. Get stamped all the way. One more. That's not all the way. One more. Do it. 25.
Well, I completed very sloppily 25 and 25, as you saw. That's Saturday. Sunday, I'm going to hit the track. I'm going to try to do 2, maybe 3 miles. I don't know. Maybe not that much. It's been about a year since I hit the track. Maybe probably a lot less than that. But I'm going to hit bleachers as well. So for now, I'm going to let y'all go. I got a couple boiled eggs that I'm cooking so I can eat my first meal of the day. And I got homework to start. And then I have work tonight, so it's going to be hard. But I got my good brother, Kevin Shaw, helping me. And his brother, Jared Shaw, both military. Thank you guys. It feels good to have former Longhorns on my side. It feels good to have a Navy SEAL, former Navy SEAL on my side. So, next time you see me, it'll be Sunday. It's Sunday. I couldn't go to the track. I'm not going to go into it. But Monday's a new day. I got some homework to do for Monday. Shaw and his brother gave me homework, so you won't see me again until Monday. Monday morning, first official day of training, and I already have a fucking setback. It seems like every time I try to do something always gotta be there to set you back. So right now I'm limping to Keensville because the tire repair place in Owaloosa wasn't open, so I gotta limp to Keensville, get my front left tire replaced, and then get my spare, which is fucked up, repaired. And then I gotta haul ass to the gym, do a 30-minute walk on the track, get something to eat, and then book it to class. I'm not even gonna have time to study for my exam. If it's not one thing, it's another.
Well, I finally made it. And this place is amazing. Everything you could have wanted. State of the art. Let's get started.
Just completed my first 30 minutes. I'm tired. Now I gotta walk down these stairs and get to class. Okay, so I have a little quick, today went pretty good. Had a mishap with a tire, threw me off all day today. Since it saved my butt. But for right now, she's here with me. I'm in the car, we're heading back. You're clear. I already told you about this new journey that I'm taking on, right? I have Caleb Shaw, ex-military. I have his brother, Jared Shaw.
Chris Pratt's trainer.
Well, I wasn't going to throw that out there at all. And Shaw is a ex-military. Jared is also ex-military. SEAL Team 4. So I'm like very excited. These guys are both, I will listen to Longhorns. They're brothers, And they're, I consider them to be brothers because of where we come from and our families were always close. But I need your honest opinion. And of course, I asked you before filming and anything else, so... The new journey I'm taking on is basically like I'm eating all meats. No breads, no tortillas, no chips, no beer. For 1 month, I gotta be beer free. And I drink my coffee. You know I love drinking my coffee, right?
Yep.
I can't have nothing but black. And black coffee makes me throw up. So this morning, I drank like this much, and it took me an hour to drink it.
You put like Sweet and Low or Splenda?
No, okay, it's nothing. It's black. You don't put shit. There's no sugar. There's nothing man-made. So a can of Wheaties, I can eat a can of Wheaties for lunch, and I'm fine, right? I have to eat up to 2,200 calories a day. And you know me. I'm like, two tacos, I'm good to dinner. Or two tacos, and then we go to lunch, and then I'm done.
And we mukbang it up.
And we mukbang it. So, like, if I do it, like, the mukbangs, my mukbang's gonna be different from now on until this whole, like, not the journey, but the whole
month
or whatever, until they tell me to change it up. Hold on, there's a car coming. There's several cars coming. So, what do you think about this whole journey that I'm doing? And these guys want me to give them 2 years of my life, and I'm like, yes, sir, yes, sir. You got it. Go ahead.
Uh-huh.
And so what do you think? I'm going to be doing this for 2 years, 30 days, no beer. And I love to drink the beer, but...
I love to drink beer, too. So I enjoy your company while I drink the beer.
Well, I can still be there with you and give you the company. It's just that for the next 30 days. And it actually officially started, like, today. But I started it yesterday or today. Yeah, today. So what do you think about the journey I'm undertaking?
Well, one thing that I can say about Jesse is that when he puts his mind to something, he really accomplishes it. Like, whether he thinks he can or he thinks he can't, if he's unsure of himself, I think, he has just that willpower or that, mind power, mind over matter kind of thing. And I think, if he can get through... 2.5 years of college at, the ripe young age that he is. I think he can do anything. I really do think so, because he sets his mind to things. Sometimes I even slack off in school because I know that he's got it covered. Like, that's how on top of shit he is. So I think, with that being said, and him being my best friend for the past, almost 3 years. I don't know, actually, since I was a kid. So, knowing him, knowing the way he is, he's persistent. He's very dedicated. When he does something and he sets his mind to it, he's dedicated, he's determined. And I'm excited to see, how it turns out. Because I think he's going to do a really good job. That's what I think.
I actually thought she was going to say, yeah, you're going to fail, motherfucker, or something like that. I'm really humbled. I mean, I've heard you
give me good speeches before, and I've heard you say, you know, say other things like that before, and it's like, it's still humbling because we're partners in Double M Productions. You know, I help you on your channel sometimes, and you help me on mine like you did now. So, thank you. It's going to be hard, man. So if you see me going for those tortillas, I actually will honestly ask you for help and smack my hand.
Just don't start getting angry at me.
Angry? No, yeah. I still got plenty of fat on me that my body will eat that before I become angry at you.
Yeah.
But I got one more question to ask you before we go on with anything else.
Sure.
I kind of would like for you to do the journey with me, but I know you're busy. I know you're really busy. And I want you to do, like, I'm asking you maybe.
I've never dieted in my life.
I'm not asking you to diet. I'm not asking you to give up anything. What I'm asking you is give me one day a week, 30 minutes on the bicycles at school. And then if you decide to go further than that, that's up to you. That's all I'm asking. One day a week so I can get your perspective on it while I film. And that's it. I mean, that's basically it. 30 minutes and you're done.
I will try. Okay. I will try my damnedest.
That sounds good.
I can promise you that.
I will try. At this point, I want to say Monday's done. And tomorrow morning, I'll be up at the track or on the bicycles. So, until today.
Until tomorrow.
My bad. Until tomorrow, guys. See you later.
I just kind of want to show you guys where I go, where I'm going to be spending my mornings. And today, it's 8:10 on a Tuesday morning. That building right there to the left. Man, this complex is beautiful, man. There you go. That's where I'll be spending most of my time.
Finish the 30-minute walk. Saw this bad boy. Did 25. It's 9 o'clock, so fasting over.
Third workout of the day, and I had some pent up frustration I need to get rid of, and I did somewhat. All right, until Wednesday. Today's Wednesday. I just did my track time, and then 25 on this abdominal machine. No joke. I'm gonna try to come back this afternoon to hit up that bike again. My legs so far have been real sore, have been killing me. My arms, since yesterday on this abdominal machine, have been killing me too. But I'm that kid that's just a little overweight. So, you know, I eat to ease the pain. We gotta rule the world, man, so. Study time, class time, film time, and then I'll get back to this. See you later. Alright, guys. I didn't get to record the final session. I had an exam all day today. I was degraded at school. I was made to feel like shit. I was called incompetent. I was told that a fifth grader would understand the material better than me. I have 108 average in the fucking class. The professor degraded me. A good friend of mine jumped in. Thank you, Suzette. Suzette actually saved me. I'm not going to say actually. She had my back today. But it did trigger my depression. After I left her, she told me, you know, just, you got, yeah, you know, we got this. Don't worry about it, dude. That when I hit the field for a bit, and I did
I didn't record because I was so fucking pissed. I didn't record because I didn't want my phone to get all fucked up. It rained, if you couldn't tell. You know, this has been a long, hard week. It's been a long, hard couple weeks, and I had to make a change in my life because I was tired of feeling certain ways. And when people degrade you and people put you down, I suffer from depression. My chest started hurting. I was getting anxiety attacks. I suffered from anxiety too. Man, I hadn't really had one that bad in years. But Suzette was there. She backed me up, man. She was in my corner. She was there when I needed her the most. And as you can tell, it's still affecting me. Suzette is one of two people who know why I truly suffer from depression. So I'm sorry I wasn't able to get, you know, the recording done. It's been a real difficult past couple of days. It's been a real difficult, you know. Today was like the hardest I've suffered in a very long time, and my mentality right now is I don't even want to go back. But I can't give up. Like she said, you can't give up. We're going to prove this motherfucker wrong. I bust my ass, dude. I fucking study. I don't have a fucking life. Today when I needed somebody the most, she was there for me. I don't have anybody in my life like everybody else does. But today my best friend backed me the fuck up. And so Friday recording on the workout, I'm sorry but I couldn't get it in because I had so much shit in my mind. I had to fucking release it. If you can't tell, I'm fucking dead right now. Whatever y'all do, man, don't let fucking people put you down the way I gotta suffer. Find somebody, talk to somebody. I'll come back to y'all, man, on Monday.